Hi everyone, we are excited to have you here in today's fun-filled learning session at YOLO. Here is a quick look at how you can submit your work after the class. As a first step, go to live.yolo.com. You can use any browser to access this site. On this page, you will see a list of all our classes. Scroll down and you can see the Submit Your Work button. And then you will see a list of the classes that you've last attended, which could, for example, show the dance or craft or science experiment classes you've attended recently. Next, it will show you the list of children whose names are registered in this mobile number. Choose your name from this list to submit your work. For instance, if you are Satvik Kumar, choose that name. And then choose the class for which you would like to make your submission. For example, if you've attended the New Year's Masquerade Party session, and you'd like to make the submission for this class, click on the Submit Your Work button below that. And then upload the photo you've taken. Choose the image from your phone and click Submit. You can scroll down and view all your past submissions and see how many of your friends or peers have liked your work. You can also see others' work and like their work to inspire your friends. If you want to showcase your work on social media, that too is very simple. Click on Share, copy the link and post it on Instagram or Facebook or any other platform of your choice. Just a tiny reminder, your submission looks a lot better if you could click a photo in the landscape mode rather than the portrait mode. Do not forget to tag us at YOLO_app. I'm eagerly looking forward to all your submissions right after this class.
Hi guys. Hello. Nice to see all my talented bunch of people here in the class 4 of our CD painting course. So we have already had 3 previous classes, one where we painted a landscape on a CD, next was one where we painted a Fruitalicious CD, and the third one, that is just the previous one, where we had a cow print CD. That was more of a therapeutic and relaxing class, and we were just enjoying that acrylic medium. And this is finally the class 4 of the course, and I didn't really realize that we have already reached to the last class of this course. And I hope that you guys have been enjoying this class and you have been attending this class consistently and also making your submissions on time. And as you all know, our motto behind this course is to make use of these outdated CDs, which are, as I said, getting outdated, and it's just our way to get creative with it and make the best use of it, because we don't see any future of using CDs anymore. So I think it's best that we use them as our canvases, paint something on it, use them in the most efficient way possible as of now. And yes, so that was it for the course. And this is the class 4 of this course. This is basically the last class of this course. And again, as usual, we are going to paint on the CDs, but this time, as I said, it would be different. Every class has been different. One where we painted a landscape, then we painted a fruit, then we had a cow print CD, and this time it's going to be a floral CD. We are going to paint some flowers on the CD this time. So I just made sure that we have something different in every class, but at the same time, as you know, we have 2 things which are constant in all the classes. Number one is the CD, and second, the acrylic paints. We have been using acrylic paints more on the CDs because, as I said, CD is not an absorbing surface. So using watercolors or poster colors or any other medium may not be feasible. It may not work out the best as it does with acrylics. And that's the reason we have been keeping the medium constant, because it is the only medium with which you can work on a CD, you can paint on a CD with. So these are the two things which remain pretty constant in our course, but one thing that keeps on changing in the course is, of course, the way we are presenting our CD, the way we are painting our CDs. So this class is again going to be something different. So make sure that you stick by till the end. And as I said, if you don't have any art materials, you don't have a CD, you don't have acrylic paints, you can just simply cut out a paper in circular form. You can use your own medium and carry out the same process that I am using here with acrylics. That's fine as well. But if you have a CD, it's the right time to make use of it the way we are doing here. So that was it. I think it's now time to just get started with the class. But just before we begin, I need quick thumbs ups coming in the chat section that yes, ma'am, we are ready for the class and let's get the fun activity started. Okay, so I want quick thumbs ups coming in the chat section. Give me a thumbs up on the screen as well. Give me a virtual high five if you're ready. So what do you have to do for a virtual high five? You simply have to place your palm in front of the screen and there we go. We had a virtual high five. So that was it. I think I have received pretty good number of thumbs up, but come on. Quickly give me thumbs up. Some more thumbs ups coming in the chat section that you guys are ready with your art materials. You're all excited for the class to get started. And then I'm going to simply share the screen. We'll discuss the art materials and then we'll begin the process. Okay, so don't worry. This class is again going to be a little relaxing, but not as relaxing as it was for the previous class. This time we are going to learn a new technique. We are going to paint flowers on the CD. So make sure that all of your eyes are carefully on the screen, okay? So, okay, I have good number of thumbs ups in the chat section. I think it's time to get started with the class and I've shared the screen. I hope all of you can see the screen as well. Yes, okay. So let's quickly discuss the art materials that are required for this course. It is nothing different. It is pretty much the same. The only thing concerned here are the shades of acrylic color. So make sure that you pay careful attention to this as well. Number one, we need a CD as usual, and we're not going to paint on the printed side, but we are going to paint on the silver side. So that's number one, a CD. Second, we need these acrylic colors. So I have a yellow acrylic paint, a black acrylic paint, and a green acrylic paint. You can skip the green acrylic paint for now. I don't think it would be necessary, but make sure you have two of these, a black and a yellow acrylic paint with you. Third, we need these paint brush. Of course, we are using acrylic paints. We'll need some paint brushes. If you have just one single brush, it's fine as well. If you have two of these, you can get both of those along with you right now at the moment. So fourth one, I have a container with water for cleaning the brush. And you all are already aware that we do not mix any water with the acrylic paints because the CD is not an absorbing surface and using water mixed with the paint will not do any good. So make sure that you're using water only for the purpose of cleaning your brushes. That's it. You need not mix the acrylic paint with a little bit of water to make it a little thinner in consistency. We don't need that. We are going to simply use acrylic paints, just the acrylic paints onto the CD without mixing any water into it. Okay. Number five, I have some paper towels over here, nothing but the tissue paper. You can also have a rough cloth along with you, just something which you use in your regular paintings to clean the brush. So either a paper towel, a tissue paper, or a rough cloth. Okay, so that is all that we need in today's class. If you're not having a CD, I'm time and again repeating that you can just cut out a piece in a circular form and you can use that as well so that you can take part in today's fun activity and you can enjoy with your friends as well. Okay, awesome. So that's all that we need. And now I think it's time to just get started. I'm going to first begin with this black acrylic paint. It is not advisable to always start with black, but this time we are not having any other option. We'll have to start with a black only. So make sure that you all are careful while using it. Just for the first time, like always, I want all of y'all to observe on the screen. And then when I'm going to repeat this process for y'all, y'all can carry it along with me. Okay, so just for the first time, I want all the eyes on the screen. Okay, so everybody is going to observe it carefully. And then I'm going to repeat it for y'all. And then you can carry out for yourself. Okay, awesome. So I'm taking a little bit of black acrylic paint onto the brush. And look, what am I creating over here? So I'm placing the brush right at the edge of the circle, the CD. And I'm going to make this semicircle. If you see, I'm making a semicircle and then I'm filling the black acrylic paint into it. So just a semicircle is what I'm making over here. Okay. So I've made the semicircle and I'm going to fill black into it. If you want, you can also increase the size of the semicircle, but make sure you have at least this size of semicircle. Now, exactly this kind of a shape, the semicircular shape with the black acrylic paint, we are going to repeat on the other edges as well. So for now, just for the first time, since all of y'all have observed it on the screen, I'm going to play it again. And this time you can carry it along with me. Okay, so now everybody going to start with the paintbrush and the black acrylic paint. So I'm repeating over here. Make sure that this time you don't miss on to the process and you're creating along with me. So just at the edge of the CD, I'm going to create a semicircle shape first. So I'm creating a semicircular shape first. Then I'm going to fill color inside it just to make it proper in shape. You can just adjust the edge of the semicircle nicely and cleanly. Okay. Awesome. So that's what I've done up till now. And now I'm going to repeat the exact semicircle on the other side. So make sure that you're carefully again observing the area where I'm creating another semicircle. So I leave a little bit of gap. I rotate the CD and I'm creating another semicircle at this area. Okay. Awesome. I've created one at this edge. I'm again going to rotate the CD and I'm going to create one just opposite the first semicircle that I've created. So now we have around three semicircles in front of us. So carefully observe the area, the location where I'm creating these semicircles. And make sure that you have enough gap between these semicircles because we are going to add more into the space. So we'll require that spaces between the semicircles as well. Okay. So all you need to do is create three of these semicircles. We don't need more of these semicircles, just three of these semicircles. Okay. So I've created three of these semicircles. Now I hope all of y'all have also created these semicircles, three of these semicircles. In case you haven't, you have ample amount of time, just quickly complete this and then we are going to move to the next step. Okay, you have ample amount of time, but that doesn't mean that you are very, very, very steady with the process. You can just speed up a little bit with a semicircle because the next thing that we are going to do requires of attention from you people. So make sure that you're just done with three of these semicircles before we proceed with the next step. Okay. So I hope that all of y'all are completed these three semicircles now. And I'm gonna quickly clean the brush now. Make sure you're getting rid of all the black acrylic paint that is there in the brush. Okay. We need absolutely clean brush. In case you're having two of these brushes, you can just clean this and keep this aside, and tiny, you can use another brush for the petals that we are going to create. If you just have one brush, make sure that you're cleaning it really, really well and just getting rid of all the black acrylic paint that we have. Okay. Awesome. Also, keeping this black paint aside now. make sure that you're not leaving your paint containers without the lid, because then they are all going to dry up. So make sure that you're closing the lid as well, keeping it all covered once you're done with its use. Okay. See, I've just cleaned the brush nice and well. We don't have any black paint with us over here. Now I'm starting with a yellow acrylic paint. And just for the first time now, since it's a new step, it's the next step, of course, but it's a new step. So I want all of you to observe it carefully on the screen. And then when I'm replaying it, you can carry along. Okay. So all eyes on the screen for the first time. So I've taken yellow acrylic paint over here with me. I have yellow acrylic paint. Just taking a little bit on the lid because I have a large container of yellow acrylic paint. So I'm going to take a little bit of it onto the lid of it. Taking the yellow brush. And now we are going to make the petals. Okay. So consider these semicircles to be the center of the flower. And then we are just going to add these petals. So are you able to guess which flower is this? Come on, it's pretty easy now since I've just begun the petals. It's pretty easy. Come on, I need the right answers coming in the chat section. What are these flowers called as? What is this flower called as? Quickly, yes. We got some correct answers. We got majorly all the correct answers. Come on, everybody attending this class, I need right answers coming in the chat section. What flower is this? Yes, so it's a sunflower. We are creating a sunflower over here, and I'm going to quickly repeat this for you in case you've missed it. So I begin just by creating this petal shape. This is just like a petal shape that I'm creating with the brush. And I'm making sure that they are more or less of the same size only. Need not make very large petals because we have two other semicircles as well. We are going to add petals to those semicircles as well. So make sure that you're having good amount of gap and not having long petals over here. Okay. So just continuing with the petals. If you feel this nice and well, you all can also get started. Okay, so get started with the petals now, just around the semicircle, just on the semicircle circumference, the edge, the border, whatever you call it as. Begin by giving these petals more or less of the same sizes. Okay, so see, we have created a part of this sunflower on one side. We are going to follow exactly the same process on the other two semicircles as well. So in case you have missed on to the process, you want to see what kind of brush stroke I'm using over here, make sure that you have your eyes carefully on the screen and you're following it this time. Okay, so do not miss it this time. I'm going to repeat it again on the next semicircle that we have over here. Okay. So taking this yellow acrylic paint now, I'm going to simply create this curved line, and then I create a curved line in such a manner that it has two pointed edges. Okay, so it has two pointed edges. This is the first pointed edge and your is the second pointed edge. Okay, so just this technique and we create these petals. As I said, make sure that you're not drawing really, really long petals because we have to accommodate. A little bit of it, if it's overlapping, that's absolutely fine. If you see over here, even mine is going to get a little overlapped with the petals, but that's fine. That's totally fine, but need not make it extremely large. Do not make the petals extremely large that you're hardly able to identify if it's a sunflower. If you see this one, it's a little overlapping, but I'm making sure that I neatly create a petal on that edge. Okay, so finally, onto the last one again. If you have missed it, it's time to just focus on the screen again, and then you can create it for yourself. Okay. So just these sunflowers on CD. So we have sunflowers on CD this time, okay? So it's a different one. As I said, we are going to have something different in all the classes. This class was also a little different, where we painted these sunflowers. I'm onto this last sunflower now, and it's now taking shape. Yes, so I'm going to take a little back. Probably let's begin with the last sunflower again, in case you have missed on to the process, or if you're a little behind what I am onto. So I'm going to take a little back over here. Let's quickly complete the last sunflower over here. And then let's see what kind of pieces you have created. Okay, so you all can show me your artworks a little later, not now. Once it's complete, you can hold it in front of your screens and I'll let you know how it looks. Just for now, quickly complete the last sunflower if you haven't already. Okay. Awesome. So we have this last sunflower taking picture, taking shape. And I already love how the CD has turned out. Yes. So if you want, you can also add a little details to the center. The center part of the flower is called as the pollen. It is the center part which contains these pollen grains. So just with this yellow acrylic paint, you can simply add tiny dots at the central portion of different sizes. Make sure you're very light with this. You can add these dots to make these pollen grains and add a little bit of detailing. Okay. So as you see, I'm giving these tiny dots at the central area. Just these tiny dots at the central area. Okay. So these are the pollen grains. I'm repeating. These are the pollen grains which are located at the center of any flower. All the flowers have pollen grains. Okay. Awesome. So that's what we created in today's class. We created these beautiful sunflowers with beautiful bright yellow petals. We created some pollen grains at the center as well. And that was it for today's class. And I hope that you enjoyed making these sunflowers on the CD. Make sure that they are really, really well dried before you use them. And this is what we have created in today's class. I hope that all of y'all enjoyed creating this with me and also enjoyed this whole course. And please do let me know which was your favorite CD and which was your favorite class of this course in the comment section, quickly in the chat section. And also, if you have any special demands of what you want to see in a course or what kind of courses you want us to come up with, make sure that you are also dropping those suggestions in the chat section or in the comments section. We'll surely see if we could come up with any of your course demands. Okay, so that was it for today. I hope you really, really enjoyed painting on CDs with me. I'll see you super soon with a new course in a new class. Till then, please take care of yourselves and also keep enjoying all the hobby classes on YOLO. Stay creative, stay healthy, stay blessed, and please do make your submissions for this class. Okay, I'll see you super soon. Bye-bye.
Hi everyone, we are excited to have you here in today's fun-filled learning session at YOLO. Here is a quick look at how you can submit your work after the class. As a first step, go to live.yolo.com. You can use any browser to access this site. On this page, you will see a list of all our classes. Scroll down and you can see the Submit Your Work button. And then you will see a list of the classes that you've last attended, which could, for example, show the dance or craft or science experiment classes you've attended recently. Next, it will show you the list of children whose names are registered in this mobile number. Choose your name from this list to submit your work. For instance, if you are Satvik Kumar, choose that name. And then choose the class for which you would like to make your submission. For example, if you've attended the New Year's Masquerade Party session and you'd like to make the submission for this class, click on the Submit Your Work button below that. And then upload the photo you've taken. Choose the image from your phone and click Submit. You can scroll down and view all your past submissions and see how many of your friends or peers have liked your work. You can also see others' work and like their work to inspire your friends. If you want to showcase your work on social media, that too is very simple. Click on Share, copy the link, and post it on Instagram or Facebook or any other platform of your choice. Just a tiny reminder, your submission looks a lot better if you could click a photo in the landscape mode rather than the portrait mode. Do not forget to tag us at YOLO_APP. I'm eagerly looking